Hi there everyone. You've probably noticed over the past few weeks I haven't been producing any videos, either here on Numberphile or my other channels. That's not some bad omen relating to the fact our last film was about the number 666. In fact, I've just been on holiday. I actually went and saw something I've always wanted to see, and that's Mount Everest. So before we get back into the usual swing of things here on Numberphile, I thought I'd share a few numbery facts about the biggest mountain in the world. So Mount Everest probably nudged its way to become the world's highest mountain about 200,000 years ago. But of course it wasn't recognised as such until about the mid-1800s during the Great Trigonometric Survey of India. Peering into the forbidden lands of Nepal and Tibet from nearly 200 miles away, I should say, surveyors calculated what they called Peak B, or Peak 15, to be exactly 29,000 feet high. Now, they didn't think anyone would believe it was exactly 29,000 feet high, so they published a height of 29,002 feet. That's 8,840 metres. Now, the British weren't really too clear on what the local names were for the mountain, and that's still a reasonably complicated debate today. So they decided they'd name it after the former survey boss, a guy called George Everest, or Everest as we call it these days. Now in the mid-1950s, not long after the mountain had been climbed for the first time, it was re-measured and the more accurate height of 8,848 metres was adopted. That's the familiar number many of us know today. More precise measurements were made in the 1990s, and things didn't change very much. Still, about 8,848 metres. But in 1999, some Americans came along using GPS, and they put a spanner in the works, publishing a new height, 8,850 metres. For many people, that still stands. Then in 2005, the Chinese came along and published a lower figure, 8,844 metres. They said the snow cap on top of the mountain shouldn't be counted, and they were using the rocky summit instead. Now, Nepal doesn't accept this argument. They're sticking with 8,848. Now, more measurements are planned at the moment. These things are always going on. And it's also worth noting that Mount Everest is actually growing by about half a centimetre, 1 centimetre every year, as the Indian continental plate smashes into China, forcing the Himalayas up. In fact, in about 1 million years, Everest would theoretically be twice as tall as it is now. But gravity and earthquakes, things like that, are unlikely to allow that to happen. And of course, Everest is only the king of the mountains when measuring above sea level. The highest mountain measured from its base to its summit is actually Mauna Kea in Hawaii. Most of this mountain, of course, is below the sea. And the furthest point from the centre of the Earth is actually the peak of this mountain in Ecuador, which benefits from the Earth's bulging waistline. But whatever the numbers say, whatever definitions you like, it's always going to be Mount Everest that captures the imagination of people like me. Now, there's a few numbers and figures about Mount Everest, but that's enough of my holiday photos. Our next Numberphile video will be back to business as usual.